Climate change is simple. We're heating up the planet, that heating up is bad, and we need to stop burning fossil fuels in order to stop it. Easy. Except, of course, that's not all there is to it. If you care about climate change, which you really should, then you'll want to go well beyond the basics, which is exactly what I'm seeing from people like environmentalists and activists. People are educating themselves about what we're doing to the planet, as well as what we can do about what we're doing to the planet. But sometimes, and I want to be real with you here, sometimes you get it wrong. And today, I, a climate scientist with a PhD from the University of Oxford, want to put you right. I asked my climate scientist Twitter friends, yes, I am cool, for some of the most common misconceptions that they come across from environmentalists. And so now, I'm going to explain to you the truth behind some of these claims. Helping me do that today is environmentalist Adam.
Hi.
And why are you standing outside in the cold?
Well, I thought it would help signify the environment.
Well, I guess we'll both regret that terrible filming decision. Okay, so let's get started as quickly as possible then.
Yes, and actually I wanted to talk to you about temperatures. You see, I heard the greenhouse gases that we've already emitted have committed us to even more warming. So much, in fact, that our emissions might already have blown us past our agreed climate limits. And that even if we stopped emitting today, the world would keep warming.
No.
But if greenhouse gas concentrations stayed constant in the atmosphere, it would take time for the oceans and ice to equilibrate. And during that time, the atmosphere would keep warming.
Okay, now that is true.
Okay, so what's the problem?
The problem is that that's not what would happen if we stopped emitting. Once we stopped, CO2 concentrations in the atmosphere would gradually decrease, cancelling out this equalization effect. So temperatures would stabilize pretty quickly, and actually we wouldn't expect to see any of this additional hidden warming.
Okay, that is a huge relief. But I heard about other sources of hidden extra warming too. Like, don't climate scientists leave feedbacks out of their calculations?
Okay, so this is a really common misconception. So feedbacks
I know what feedbacks are. They're ways that the climate system responds to our emissions that either amplifies or reduces their warming effects.
I couldn't have said it better myself. So yes, if we want to know how much global warming we're really in for, we need to take account of these feedbacks.
Exactly.
Which is why climate scientists do take account of them. Now, not all climate models include the feedback of melting permafrost. Permafrost, by the way, is frozen soil with
trapped carbon in it.
But in general, climate scientists do work hard to include all possible feedbacks in their estimations of how much the world will warm or how long we have to cut our emissions.
Ah, but what about aerosols? These tiny droplets and particles cool the climate, and so when we stop emitting them, that cooling effect will stop, and the world will heat up.
Yep, which is why climate scientists work out how big this warming effect would be, and take it into account when they're assessing limits.
Like working out how much CO2 we can emit before the world heats up too much?
Exactly.
Okay, but what about methane?
You mean the greenhouse gas that breaks down after about a decade, but ton for ton heats the planet more than carbon dioxide over the course of a century?
Yes, obviously that's what I mean. And there are huge amounts of methane trapped in frozen soil and underwater. And as the world heats up, all of that methane could suddenly be released, increasing the world's temperatures by huge amounts in a short amount of time.
Now this is a massive topic, and a topic that many are understandably quite scared of. And the truth is that these methane stores could add to the world's warming, and add to it quite substantially.
So you're saying that I got this one right?
I'm afraid not. The evidence suggests that this methane would release gradually, not in one big sudden burst. So limiting the amount of human emissions of greenhouse gases would limit the amount of extra methane that's emitted, which would limit the amount of extra warming, which is good, within limits.
That sounds like a complex, nuanced topic that you should make an entire video about.
You know what, environmentalist Adam? I was thinking exactly the same thing.
Okay, but I heard a scientist called who said that climate scientists hadn't accounted for all this stuff, and it's actually much worse than mainstream scientists say.
And does this have any relevant experience in the subjects we're discussing?
Well, no, their work doesn't really concern oceanic or atmospheric dynamics, but I'm pretty sure they're right and all you climate scientists are just shill.
Now, this is a comment that climate scientists get a lot, and I can understand not being sure who to trust. But at the end of the day, choosing one expert, regardless of their actual expertise or evidence, and then dismissing all other climate scientists because they don't agree, well, does that sound like the strategies of anyone else that climate scientists have been having to argue with for decades?
Okay, point taken. But I'm just scared that you climate scientists are just playing it down.
Now, some do argue this, but for very many aspects of the climate, including for global temperatures, there is absolutely no evidence of climate scientists being too cautious. The thing is that the scientific evidence we already have is scary enough. We climate scientists don't feel the need to exaggerate it or downplay it.
Well, do you have any recommendations for climate scientists who do present a balanced perspective on the state of our understanding?
Well, I am so glad you asked. There is a list in the description of this video.
Okay, but what about the driving forces behind climate change? I heard that the real problem is meat. I heard that the real problem is flying. The real problem is plastic.
As you may have guessed, all of these are problems, but no single one of them is the real problem. Climate change is caused by all greenhouse gas emissions, and important contributions to that do come from transportation and from agriculture. But fixing these two sectors by themselves isn't enough to fix climate change. As for plastic, that's not really a major driving force behind global warming. That said, it does still have other major environmental impacts, so don't just go around littering.
Sorry.
Climate change is complicated, so be wary of anyone who says there's only one specific cause, just like anyone who says
there's one specific solution. If we just build more carbon capture, more nuclear fusion, more hydrogen, then it'll be problem solved.
The truth is that stopping climate change is complicated. We need to get to net zero emissions globally in all sectors. What works in some places might not work in others, and so there's no one single life hack that can just magically solve climate change for us. And yes, that includes renewables, which without some kind of storage wouldn't be able to provide the stable electricity supply that we need, never mind get rid of emissions in sectors like agriculture.
Ah, but what about the amazing climate change fighting gadget that I heard about in the news?
As with any new technology, it takes time to scale things up and to make them economical, which is why we really shouldn't hold our breath, especially as we need to start cutting emissions yesterday.
Wait, so are you saying that we're too late?
Well, yes and no, but mostly no. You see, the best time to start cutting emissions would have been 20 years ago, but the second best time is right now.
But I keep seeing headlines saying that our limits are slipping out of reach.
Now, honestly, this is true. Keeping global warming under the limits of the Paris Climate Agreement will be incredibly tough, especially the more ambitious limit of 1.5 degrees Celsius. But the thing is, climate change isn't binary. It's not fine before we pass a limit and a complete catastrophe afterwards. Every bit of warming costs us money, and costs us lives. And so every bit of warming we can avoid matters.
So you're saying that it's never too late to stop punching ourselves in the face?
You know what? That is exactly what I'm saying.
Yeah, I saw your video. But this whole time you've just been saying everything that I've got wrong. So are you saying that people who care about climate change should just shut up?
No, that is the last thing that I'm saying. I am just so amazed by what the climate movement has managed to achieve these last couple of years. And when I speak to people who are fighting to keep the planet as livable as possible, I'm not just blown away by their passion, but also by their incredible knowledge.
Shut.
No, for real. I mean, I want to put straight a few misconceptions, but in general, there is an amazing level of scientific literacy. Of course, at the same time, it would be unrealistic to expect anyone to get everything right 100% of the time, especially in a topic as complicated as this one.
Well, where can I learn more?
Well, there are links in the description of this video to the original Twitter thread, as well as more information behind every single topic that we've discussed. But if you want to know more and have a question of your own, why not leave it in the comments below? And if you learned something from this video,
which I certainly did,
well then be sure to give it a like and share it around. Okay, until next time. Bye.
Any droplets and particles? Oh, Jesus Christ.